Hello, my dear students, class 5th. Last week we have studied the kinds of sentences. Now, today we will learn the text lesson. Lesson number 1, Chaskit goes to school. Feeling excited? Okay, let's start. How do you go to school? Probably by bus, auto rickshaw or with your parents, right? If I ask you that do you like to go to school? You would answer yes. I like to go to school. I know how much you are attached with your school. Why? Because you enjoy learning and also playing in the school, right? So how would you feel if you see someone from your area where you live is not able to go to school for some reason of physical disability? Will you feel good? No, na? So here is a lesson, Chaskit Goes to School, written by Sujata Padmanabhan. Sujata Padmanabhan is a writer. She is a trained special educator and she had worked with children with multiple disabilities in Delhi for 10 years. So moving towards our lesson, look at these pictures. Why? What are they doing? Are they enjoying themselves? Do you think it is easy for them to do what they are doing? I think your answer would be no, right? Okay. Now I am showing here some characters in the story of the story. That is Abale, means father. Amale means mother. Memele means grandfather. Amchi means a doctor who has been trained in Tibetan medicine. Abdul is a friend. And one more character is Stockton. Okay, so looking at these characters, so let's start the lesson. Chaskit goes to school. All of you open page number 2 and let's go by each line. I will be explaining you after every paragraph. Okay. Chaskit woke up early that morning. It was a very special day and she was too excited to sleep. She eagerly looked out of the room through the window. Next to her bed, it was springtime in Ladakh and the apricot trees were in full bloom. Two magpies had already began their work and they were busy by looking insects for her. Her Amale also awake too. Chaskit here, she hear her making gurgurti. So Chaskit woke up early because she was too excited, because it was very special day for her in her life. If you have something special, if you have something special plans, and if you are going to some favorite places, and if you do have something favorite, obviously you get up early and will be really active in that morning. You are so eagerly that something going to be happen in your day, in your life. The same thing happened with the Chaskit. As she woke up looking to the window, she found the apricot trees was full of in bloom. The apricot is a tree where you find these type of trees you can find near the lakes or ponds. Looking to the window, she found the apricot tree was full of in bloom. The apricot is a tree where you find these type of trees you can find near the lakes or ponds. Also, there were magpies. Magpies is a kind of bird which has long tail. That bird also means magpie. It also started her day by looking for insects to eat. Then Chaskit's mom wake up, which is mentioned here, Amale, is in the kitchen making gurgurti. What is a gurgurti? Gurgur tea is a butter tea that is made in a long cylindrical vessel, wooden vessel. The tea is churned with a butter, salt and milk in the vessel. The low gurgur noise is produced during the churning. So that is gurgur tea. Chaskit mother was making. Now we will move to the next para. Chaskit had been awake for the last hour. This was the day she was going to remember for a long time. Today was going to be Chaskit's first day at school at 9 years. She had waited a long time for this. So it's been 1 hour to be awake, but she looking through the windows. It is really looking through the windows that was memorable for Chaskit. Because after 9 years, after long awaiting, Chaskit is going to school at last. See the next para. It is, the Chaskit was not very far from her home to get there. You had to walk up to the main road just before the prayer wheel. You look the path to be left of the road that ran along the narrow stream near the poplar trees. Okay, you cross the tree, the stream, by jumping over the big rocks. Once you got to the other side, a short walk up a slope to the school. So here it's not like you people coming in the school. People coming in the school by bus or any other transport, with rickshaw uncle or some parents coming all from the ways of 7 to 8 kilometers, right? So the school was not very far from her home. To get there, you had a walk up to the main road just before the prayer wheel. Okay, so the way is the way has been explained here very clearly. You have to walk up to the main road, and just before the prayer, you took the path to the left of the road to the narrow stream. So need to take a left side of the road, which has also a narrow stream beside, and near the poplar trees. Just you cross the stream by jumping over the big rocks. So the trees, rocks are there. The road is not even. So once you got to the other side by crossing all these, a short walk take you to the school. This short walk is among the trees, rocky area, uneven road. So this is the way is not easy as the plain road, right? Are you getting me? So all the children, now see the next paragraph. All the children of Skitpoyal. Skitpoyal is a Chaskit's village, okay, walk to the school every day and with ease. But not little Chaskit, she had a disability and could not walk. So Skitpoyal, that is a Chaskit's village where she used to live in the village. All the children from this village walk to the school easily every day, but little Chaskit could not go to the school. Why? Because she had a disability and she could not walk. Disability means a condition that limits a person physically or mental ability. Okay, so she is not normal like you and me. The children with disabilities have some limits. So we should feel lucky, and also we should thank to our parents for this. And because Chaskit has a disability, she cannot go to the school. See the next para. That is, Chaskit was born with legs that did not work like everyone else. Her father had taken her to the village Amchi and then to the doctors in Leh. But No amount of medicine had helped her walk. At first, Chasqui did not realize that she was anyway different from Stockton, her younger brother or her cousin. But soon there were many things she could not do as easy as them. So moving towards the next line, that does not matter. Her Abale would tell her whenever she felt sad, "You can stitch better than any one of them. And you draw very well." Abale often brought her some color pencils from Leh. Okay. So here, whenever Chasqui felt sad or disappointed, her father Abale always used to tell her that it doesn't matter if she couldn't do the things easily. He always encouraged her that you can stitch better than anyone. Also, you can draw very well. He often brings color pencils from Leh. Leh is a town where the market would be there, right? So, see the next para. Chasqui would sit at the kitchen window every day and draw what she saw while her Amale cooked. She could see her family's animals then taken to graze every morning. She could see the blue waters of the stream that flowed nearby. And she would be the first one to announce the arrival or visitor to their house. So Chasqui probably used to sit at the kitchen window every day by drawing what she saw in the kitchen where Amale cooked. Also, she would see the pets, animals grazing every day. She had a good artistic vision, which Chasqui always, we feel that she would see the blue water through the windows. She would be the first to notice that someone or guest or visitors arrive to the house. See next, Chasqui used a wheelchair to move around. You could move it any direction, forward, left, right, and even backward. By moving the ways with your hands, you only needed to have really strong arms to push the way of your body and the chair as well. So here, as we know that Chasqui had no ability to walk, she had to move the wheelchair in any direction, left, right, forward, backward. How? By moving the wheels with her hands. If you want to move wheelchair, you have really strong arms to push the weight of the body and the chair as well. Right? So, I think for today, let us stop here. I think after this video, read the text on page number 2 very carefully. Then write day and lesson name in the margin. Write new words which are given on the page number 1 and 2. After writing new words, read the part of the lesson thoroughly and try to understand it. The next part of the lesson we will see on Wednesday. Till that, bye.